This is big. We definitely should work it out immediately. Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU channel. Yesterday, the Stability AI team proudly released SDXL 1.0, an open model and the next iteration in the evolution of text-to-image generation models, following the limited research-only release of SDXL 0.9. The full version of SDXL has been improved to become the world's best open image generation model. I suppose you want to try it out immediately, just like me. Let's do it. First, browse the main content and find the model download link. It is available on GitHub. Go to the page and find SDXL Base 1.0 and SDXL Refiner 1.0. Click the small download file icon to start downloading. I'm a little bit surprised that the base model is smaller than the 0.9 test model, which is about 13.6 GB. It will take a while to finish downloading. Now, let's check the homepage again. It is said you can try it for free on ClipDrop. Click the link here. You can see a new page pop up, and you can directly input the prompt here. Here are some more details you can tweak, but it seems not to work directly. Click the generation button. Now another pop-up menu appears. You can choose to subscribe for faster image generation, probably not free. Or you need to do further steps to activate it. Back up to the former page. I just want to try it out now by clicking skip. Now we can see quite a lot of people waiting. You are now on the list. The waiting is fast, and then we get the image. It will generate 4 images at once, and you can select them and download them to your computer. The image quality is quite good. Back to our downloading, it is finished. If you have watched my previous video, you will know that ComfyUI can use Stable Diffusion models directly without downloading. So, put the model into the Stable Diffusion folder is the best way. Move these two files to your Stable Diffusion WebUI Automatic1111 folder and start WebUI Automatic1111. We can see the checkpoint here and select the base model 1.0. It works. Great. Input something in the prompt and select the resolution 1024 and 2024, since this model is trained in this resolution. And it is said it will generate better images. The first time you run it, it will download the necessary packages, they said. It takes a long time to generate the image. It takes 9 minutes, 55 seconds. And the picture is really beautiful. The Chrome PNG info still does not work for me. So sad. I go back to using Avast browser again. This time, I try a more complicated prompt that I used a long time ago, with a resolution of 1024x2024. It took about 6 minutes and 51 seconds to finish the image generation. Then I send it to image to image. You should remove the LoRa, otherwise it may give you error messages. This time it took 3 minutes and 19 seconds. The picture is very nice and has a lot of detail. Next, I try upscaling directly without using control net. I use 4x upscale sharp, and it took 5 minutes and 57 seconds. The image quality is really good. After that, I use the inpaint function to change the eye to green. It took 6 minutes and 50 seconds to finish, but I don't know why the eye color is not changed. I also try upscale the image from 2048 to 4096. It took 5 minutes and 6 seconds. Compared with the original figure, the detailed image is extremely beautiful. Then I try control net. I try Kanye first. And it took 3 minutes and 27 seconds. But it gave me an error message. It seems SDXL is still not finally optimized for Automatic1111 yet. Then I changed the checkpoint to the old model, such as Dream Shape for testing. It took 5 minutes and 36 seconds. It works very well.
The image quality is almost the same as that directly used upscale function by the SDXL motor.
We can get good images using the base motor or even the refiner motor. The impant and upscaling function can be used as well, but it takes a long time. However, the image quality is really good. Now let's try ComfyUI.
It already reached the number 2 position on Stable Diffusion Ecosystem ranking, just below the top WebUI Automatic1111. We did not need to download any motors at all, just modify the extra motor pass YAML file. As I described in the last video, ComfyUI did not separate text to image or image to image. They treated them as similar nodes, and you can use any of them.
I load a workflow that I designed for using refiner and 4x scaling. I input the prompt and start generating the image. It only took 34 seconds to generate the base image, 48 seconds to generate the refined image, and 55 seconds for the 4x scaled images. Very fast. Let's look at the image. We can see all of the images are very good. The refiner adds some details to the eye brushes, etc. And the 4x scaled image is extremely beautiful. Now let's try Control Net. Unfortunately, Control Net also does not work now. However, if I change the Control Net motor to an old motor, such as Dream Shape, it will work. But the image is not as good as I expected. I still haven't figured out what the problem is. If I load the image that SDXL generated and use the normal control net workflow, the open pose will give me a completely different image. But the tire function will give me a very nice image with a lot of new details. To sum up, ComfyUI works very well with the SDXL motor. It can combine the refiner directly in the workflow, and the image generation speed, including 4x upscaling, is extremely fast compared to the WebUI Automatic1111. However, the control net can work, but there are still some issues to be solved. That's the test result for today. If you enjoy my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.